गिरु ओआ गिरु ओआ गिरु ओआ गिरु
गुरु
ओआ गिरु
वाह गुरु 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 वाह वाहिगुरु जी का खालसा, वाहिगुरु जी की फतेह। So the seventh pauri which we are going through of Asa Ki War, we did the first slok by Guru Nanak Dev Ji, which was about the ego. This whole pauri is about the ego. The second one is from Mohalla Dooja by Guru Angad Dev Ji, and it is on the same lines as Guru Nanak Dev Ji. But we need to ponder, right, what home is, what ego is. We know everything. In Vedas, it is called Ahambhav. Ahambhav as in Ahankar or an ego. So that's why when we talk about the five vices, it's Kaam, Krodh, Lo, Moh, Ahankar. So the Ahambhav or the feeling of I is the most prominent vices. This is the most prominent vice from the five vices in human beings. So if you, if you ponder on Gurbani more and more, it all talks about tu, 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 as in you, rather than I. Even we read this all the time, Aapas ko jo pala kahave, tise palai nikat naave. What does it mean? That someone who says that I am the best, nobody is better than me, actually the good things never even come close to him, because he's doing everything because of his ego, right? And you know, Gurbani talks about, there's a Shabad which I'm going to share with you guys, it talks about how home is the most prominent disease in human beings. No doubt there are others also, lust, greed, anger, attachment. But the ahankar or ahambhav or home is considered as the biggest one. That's what Guru Arjan Dev Ji in Pairo Raag he talks about. He says, home rog manukh ko dina. This is the biggest prominent disease which Guru Sahib has given to, which Vaheguru has given to the human beings. Kaam rog magal bas leena. Similarly, for other animals, there are different, prominent diseases. There are other diseases also. Humans have lust also. Humans have greed also. Humans have anger also. But for humans, home is the number one disease. Because all other diseases are connected with home for humans. But for magal, as in for an elephant, it is different. It is kamrog. It is lust. In the olden times, maybe you can see some documentaries also. when they had to catch the elephant, what they used to do was they used to dig a big hole and they used to put a fake female elephant out there. And the elephant used to go crazy about it. And he used to follow that female elephant. And then they used to put that female elephant into that hole. And they used to capture the male elephant by that. So that showed that actually it had a lot of lust. And Gurbani says that, kaam, rog, magal, rog. Rog is what? Rog is disease, right? Home rog, it is called a disease. It's a disease. Home rog, manuk ko dina, kaam rog, magal baslina. Drisht rog, pachmue patanga. What is patanga? Patanga is a moth, right? If you see, you know, the small insects or the flies, which actually goes around the flame, what happens? They burn themselves in the flame because they have a drisht rog. Their eyesight. So if you think about the panj indriya, right? The karam indriya. So the sight and, you know, every other thing, the smell and the touch and all that, all these vices are connected with that, right? So for the moth, it's eyesight. It is so focused on the flame that it forgets that if it will go in the flame, it will burn itself. Similarly about the human beings, they forget about it, that every decision, every action which we take is about home, everything about me, how I will do this. I am not ready for this. I am going to do this. It's all I. We forget that because of this I thing, we will come and go again and again because we want to keep our existence. Till the time our existence is there, Vaheguru's existence is not there. Very simple. Vaheguru's existence will be there if our existence will not be there. We will read more about that in Asa Ki War, but I just wanted to give you this Shabad. You can focus on this. Naad rog khap muye kuranga. So basically at the end, Maharaj is talking about that kuranga is a deer. So if today also, if they have to capture a deer, they basically ring a bell. So that's what the naad rog, naad as in the sound. With the sound, the disease of sound, basically deer follow that sound and it gets captured. Similarly, we get captured because of our home. Somebody challenges us for something, we go with that, and then basically we get captured by the maya. Jojo dise so so rogi. Maharaj says, whatever living being you see, they have some kind of disease. Who has not any disease? Rog rahat mera satguru jogi. Only Vaheguruji doesn't have any rog, any disease. Otherwise, everybody has some kind of a disease. Every living being has some kind of a disease. But for humans, the number one prominent disease is not lust, is not greed, it's not anger, but home, ahambhav, the ego. Because of the ego, we get so much trapped that's why Maharaj is calling it a rogue. It is a disease. So let's move to our the Shabad by Guru Angad Dev Ji. It's similar line as the Slok Mahalla Pehla. Home eha jat hai. Home karam kamae. Home ehi bandana. Fir joni paaye. Home kitho upjae. Kit sanjam e jaye. Home eho hukam hai. Paye kirt firaye. Home dirag rog hai. Daru bhi ismaye. Kirpa kareje apani. Ta gur ka shabad kamae. Nanak kahe suno jano, it sanjam dukh jaye. As we were discussing about the home, so, you know, why we need a home, right? So we are basically trying to prove, I know this, I am better than others, right? Sun never says that I can remove the darkness, because it has to prove it. Its properties, its quality of the sun is that it will remove the darkness, and the morning will come, and the light will come. That's a quality. Sun doesn't have to say, hey, I remove the darkness. Similarly, we don't need this, this eye. Sandalwood, for example, there's a lot of examples in Gurbani about the sandalwood. Sandalwood has a very good fragrance, right? But it never says that, hey, I have a fragrance, come to me. You are far away and you can smell it. You can feel it, that there is somewhere a sandalwood. Even it is even said that next to the sandalwood tree, if there is another tree, they also start giving a good fragrance. So that's why we say that, okay, we need to do sangats of Gurmukhs, because whatever type of sangat we will do, that's what we will become. So if you will see, the people's viewpoint changes, right? Whatever you are near, whatever kind of people you are near, that's how you will become. So if you will be near the sandalwood, you will become sandalwood, right? But sandalwood is not saying, I am sandalwood. It's not saying, I. Similarly, on the same basis, don't get offended. People say, oh, my religion is better. My caste is the best. My ethnic origin is the best. My language is the best. My country is the best. Maharaj says, if you have that feeling, my thing, that means you want your existence. What will happen with that? Again, born again and again, come into different jewels, because you want your existence to be there all the time. At the end also, you are talking, you're thinking about your family, my kids. I did this. I did masters. I did PhD. I am a computer engineer, right? I am the prime minister. What is happening in India right now? Again, we are dealing with the home of our Prime Minister Modi, right? And there is so much, there are lakhs of people, millions of people on one side, and then there are few people in the government on one side. Because of their ego, they don't want to listen to millions of people. So much home we have, right? And that is the thing which we need to learn from Gurbani, right? Gurbani is talking about, and the people, even the farmers have started saying there, this is no longer a farmer movement. This is movement of everybody. It is for everybody, because there is no home left, right? There is no home left in that, right? Yeah, one can argue, hey, they are fighting for their existence. That is fine. But if you think about it, the more bigger we have, the smaller Vaheguru will become. Everyone else will be smaller in front of an egoistic. Everyone. The egoistic or the arrogant person will never have friends. We can give an example of a Hitler. Hitler didn't have many friends, or probably no friends. Because in friendship, what we need is equality. Right? So that's why Maharaj is saying, Home eha jat hai, home karam kumaye. Home is just like a different path. Every action we do, home karam kumaye, every action we'll do is full of home. About me, I. Home ei bandhana, fir jo nahi paaye. It is like a bandhan, right? Because we don't want to let go our I property, our existence ever. What will happen? We'll come and go back again and again. Basically, this is, we will always be in the cycle of life and death. Fir juni pai, we will come back in 8.4 million junes again and again. Now there's a question. Maharaj says, Home kitho upje, kit sanjam e jaye. From where this home is coming? What is the root of this home? And what can we do to remove this home? How can it be removed? It's a question. Maharaj gives an answer. Maharaj says, Home eho hukam hai, paye kirt firaye. Maharaj says, Home is a hukam. It's an order of Vaheguru. When Vaheguruji created us, he created the home also. What does that mean? You can consider yourself big. What is the hukam? Maharaj says, it's up to you. You can consider yourself big, or you can consider your Vaheguruji big. Basically, you can consider God big, or you can consider yourself big. But what is happening is, in these days, ego is at the top. In the whole world, it's not only in India or in a particular, in the whole world, if you think, even in America, we went through a rule of Trump and all that stuff, right? What was happening out there? Ego was big, right? So everybody is basically in every lifespan, all our actions are related with ego. The more bigger ego is, we are forgetting about the God. If you will talk about like in this world at this point of time, most of the people are atheist. They say God doesn't exist. Vaheguruji doesn't exist because of their ego. What we do is the best. What we are doing is the best. It doesn't exist. God doesn't exist. Right? And next line, Maharaj says, Hum me dhirag rog hai, daru bhi isma hai. Maharaj says, Hum me is a dhirag rog. What is a dhirag rog? A long duration disease. It's not like I have it today and I will not have it tomorrow. Or within few days, it will go away. No. But man or a human is born with ego, dies with ego. But how to remove it, right? How to remove it? Now we know that the source of home is Vaheguruji itself. Vaheguruji gave us the home. What is that home? Either you consider me big or you consider yourself big. Right? If somebody is saying, I, you know, there is a Sakhi actually. You know, when Guru Arjan Dev Ji was collecting the Gurbani of different Pagats, there was one Pagat, his name was Pagat Kanha Ji. Pagat Kanha Ji came, and there are no Shabads of Pagat Kanha Ji in Gurbani, in Guru Granth Sahib Ji, just to let you know. But he came to Guru Arjan Dev Ji. He said, please put my Bani also in Guru Arjan Dev Ji. Guru Arjan Dev Ji, he came to Guru Arjan Dev Ji's court in his Darbar. And Guru Arjan Dev Ji asked him, okay, let's see what you have to say. So this is written in the history that he started his words with main ohi re, main ohi re. And just with the first lines, when he said main ohi re, I am the one, I am the one, I am the same one, I am the same one, Guru Arjan Dev Ji said, stop it here. Because his writing started with I am the one, I am the one. Rather than saying you are the one, you are the one, he was saying I am the one. So that proved that he didn't move to that level, to that, you know, topmost level, to the chautha pad. Give me a second here. Home dhirag rog hai, daru bhi isma hai. So we were talking about Pagat Kanha Ji, right? So the moment he said I, Guru Sahib knew that he has not reached to the chautha pad. Maybe he goes and come back. He has not understood that it is, if you have to remove your existence, if you want to meet Vaheguruji, the first thing which we need to do is remove our existence. And trust me, saying is very easy, but actually doing it is very difficult. That's why here is Home me dhirag rog hai, दारु भी इस्माहे, द मेडिसिन ऑफ द होमे इज विद इन अस. सम पीपल गेट कंफ्यूज, दे थिंक दैट महाराज इज सेइंग दैट होमे इज अ दारू ऑल्सो, बट महाराज इज सेइंग दारू भी इस्माहे, विद इन आर सेल्फ इज द होमे. वाहेगुरु जी हैज पुट द होमे एंड द दारू, द मेडिसिन इज ऑल्सो विद इन अस. वट इज दैट दारू? दैट इज द नाम. एंड द नेक्स्ट लाइन प्रूव दैट, कृपा करे जे अपनी ता गुर का शब्द कमाहे. महाराज सेज इफ इट इज हिज कृपा देन द वन द ह्यूमन बीइंग विल डू द कमाई ऑफ विल अर्न द नाम विच इज अ गुप्त नाम. गुप्ते नाम कलयुग वर्ते राइट इन द कलयुग द नाम विच इज गुप्त इज इनसाइड अस. एंड व्हेन वी विल डू द कमाई, व्हेन वी विल पुट आवर ध्यान inside that naam, then home will go away. That's the only way. There is no other way till the time we put our dhyan inside. Now you guys are doing you know, every Saturday we are having the session, right? The guided meditation session where we talk about how to put a dhyan. And you guys know that when we put a dhyan, and maybe you're trying at home also, I'm expecting that, I'm assuming that. I should not expect anything, sorry about that. But I'm assuming that everybody's trying that, just like I am trying, right? Again, I, with the Vaheguruji's kirpa. So that's the thing which we need to remind ourselves. With the Vaheguruji's kirpa, we are trying. So if we will try that, we know that when we go in that sun state, in the samadhi state, there is no home. But we need to have that state all the time. Yes, we will need a little bit of a home all the time to do our actions, right? But at minimal, whatever it is needed for, not all the time, right? We don't need that. Yes, to do worldly actions, we need home. Otherwise, we're done. For everything which is given to us, there is a reason. So we have to cut this disease into the half, to the minimal, right? Kirpa kare je apni ta gur ka shabd kamaye, Nanak kahe suno jano it sanjam dukh jaye. Maharaj says, listen everybody, this is the jukti, this is the technique, that's the way your home, your dukh, your pain will go away. By how? Kirpa kare je apni गुरु का शब्द कमाए, by putting the ध्यान in गुरु दा शब्द. First we have to put the ध्यान in गुरु शब्द, which is वाहेगुरु. वाहेगुरु, वाहेगुरु, तुन में ध्यान. महाराज says, तुन में ध्यान, ध्यान में जानिया गुरमुख कथ कहानी. The sound, the voice coming from you, first we have to put the ध्यान there. Then after that we have to put the ध्यान in the शब्द which is inside us. There is a funny story which I learned few days back. There is a Sufis, some of the Sufis, they used to believe that when Vaheguruji created this world, what happened was that he was feeling bored. It's a funny story, right? And so that's why he created a human beings, right? So he started like living with them and all that stuff. And then the slowly population grew. And, there were a lot of people then. Then there was a problem. Not everybody started respecting him or loving him. So there were some people who hated him, right? Then Vaheguru decided, the God decided that, hey, I am not going to be, I don't want this hate. I will hide myself from these guys. So he said, okay, where should I hide myself? He thought, oh, maybe he should go and live in the mountains. But then he realized, hey, if I will live in the mountains, what will happen is that they will somehow find me there. Then he said, why not to hide myself in the sky? They said, maybe, maybe they will invent a device like we have now, aeroplanes and all, right? And they might come to the sky and find me there. And he said, maybe under the water. Then again, he decided they will find something to go under the water, under the ocean, and they will still find him. He said, oh, there is one place where they cannot find me. I will hide myself inside everybody. And they said that millions and billions and trillions of, he divided himself into millions and billions and trillions of jyot, of light, and he went in everybody. And so, and now everybody's looking outside, but he is sitting inside. It's a funny story, but it makes sense in terms of that he is in everybody. So there are a lot of other faiths that believe also that Vaheguruji is inside us. Bahar tonle so parampulai. If we'll search it outside, we will never find him. He's inside us, right? And we have to put a tyan. And that's what the next pauri is all about. And this will be the end of seventh pauri. Pauri sev kiti santokhi jinni sacho sach tyaya unhi mande pair na rakhyo karso kritik taram kamaya unhi duniya tode bandhna an pani thoda khaya tu bakshishi agla nit deve chade savaya वड्याई वड्डा पाया वड्याई वड्डा पाया. So Maharaj here is saying सेव कीती संतोखी जिनी सच्चो सच ते आया. He said the only people who can give away their home will be who will put their dhyan in the sach, and they will be the santokhi, the people who will be content. Right? They will be satisfied. They will be satisfied from all the ways. They will not have this, thing. Oh, I want this. I want that. I want to be a millionaire. I want to be a billionaire. I want to be a trillionaire. The people who will have a santok, satisfaction, contentment, right? Those are the ones who can put a dhyan in the sach. When they will put their dhyan, when they will put their focus in the sach which is inside them, unhi mande pair na rakhyo kar sukrit taram kamaya, then they will do the kamai of taram, honesty. Mande pair na rakhyo, they will not do any sin. What a sin? They will not go behind their thoughts in their head. What is happening right now? Whatever thought will come, we go behind them. That's a sin, basically. We are moving in these nine doors again and again, going behind our thoughts because of our ego. Now Maharaj is giving 100% solution, how to remove this ego, right? How to remove I. How to go into a ability of tu, you. Unhi doniya tode bandhana, an pani thoda khaya. These are the nishani. The people who will break these bonds, these bandhans, the nishani is an pani thoda khaya. An is what? Flour means roti, pani. Basically, the food, their intake of food will be less and less. What happens? We all know the more food we eat, we not only go fat, but we get lazy. I know for myself, right? If I'll have a heavy food, right? Have a puriya and my friend is here. He says that you always talk about the food, but that's a reality. Gurbani is talking about it. Yeah, puriya, lassi and all that stuff. My favorite example to give is aloo wale kulche, or paneer or rajma rice or something. More and more we eat, we will go lazy. When we go lazy, we say, oh, we are putting a dhyan, we are going in sun, but we are not in sun. What we are doing is sleeping, right? So the person who will be satisfied, he will not eat much food also, right? That's why Maharaj is saying, unhi duniya tode bandhana, an pani thoda khaya. Again, listen here. Maharaj is not saying don't eat food. Maharaj is not saying always be on fast. Eat whatever is required. right? Eat, you have to eat, right? Mahajan saying don't eat, but eat whatever is required. Oni duniya tode bandana ann pani thoda khaya. Tu bakshishi agla nit deve chade savaya. You will forgive their sins. Maharaj is compassionate. If somebody has come back to the feet of Vaheguru, started doing the meditation, stopped doing nindya chugli, gossiping, slandering, hating others, stopped doing I, Maharaj will forgive him or her. Tu bakshishi agla nit deve chade savaya. Then you will basically bless them each and every day. What is the blessing here? We will start walking on the path of live. Maharaj in Gurbani says, live taat doe ra hai. Taat is goes towards maya. Live is goes towards Vaheguru, in the love of Vaheguru. We'll keep on going in soon. We'll keep on removing all our sins, all the mal, all the filth will go away. Mind will be pure, right? Mind will be pure like anything. And then we can meet Vaheguru. Vadeai vada paya. Vadeai vada paya. And we will do his praises. And at the end, we will meet Vaheguru. So in theory, to summarize this, this is all about meeting Vaheguru. So the biggest bandhana is our homing, our ego. So the moment we will remove our existence, his existence will come and we will not have to born again. Because if we say we want to exist, oh, I have some left endeavors in the world, I need to come back. Obviously, you will come back. You have that desire to come back. Oh, I miss my parents. Oh, I miss my kids. Oh, I miss my wife. I miss some things. You die, you have to come back again, no matter what you did. Whether you did good karams or bad karams does not matter. You will come back again. So the existence of I, we have to continuously check ourselves that how much I we are doing. The more I we are doing, the more aham bhav is there, the more arrogance is there. I know better, right? The only way. That's why another, remember we learned home dhirag rog hai daru bhi ismay. The another explanation is that home, when I say I, sometimes we can convert this I into you. For example, we start with I want to meditate. I want to put a tyan. Then with Vaheguruji's kirpa, when you put a tyan and when your tyan is successful, when your focus to the such is successful, what happens at that point of time? Your home turns into a medicines and it becomes a naam. So naam and home, they are opposite to each other. Gurbani says, home naave naal virodh hai. Doe na base ik thai. Where there is home, there is no naam. Where there is naam, there is no home. Very simple. They cannot be at the same time, at the same place. Either you are jumping naam with Vaheguruji's kirpa or you have a home. Or you're saying, oh, you're telling others, oh, I do Amrit Vela. I jump naam, I wake up 1 in the morning, right? I wake up 4 in the morning, whatever it is, right? When we say I, then that means you exist, Vaheguruji doesn't exist. Your home exists, naam doesn't exist. All right? So are there any questions on this? If not, then what we are going to do is we are going to go into our guided meditation session and I am going to stop the recording.